God will forgive the person that called me. God will forgive you. I don't count it as sin against you, but my Jesus Christ, God in heaven will forgive you. So thank God. I didn't know that we have really gone far in this prayer. I'm so grateful. I was thinking that, how will I manage this time that it looks long? But thank God, God is taking control. And I'm so grateful. So, that prayer was very strong. We are trying to cancel the foundational battles from the foundational causes. Whether it's causal, whether it's battle, whether it's anything coming from the foundation, trying to cause distractions. Some people will now start coming seriously, they will be hurting very right. But one thing God told me is that the rightful person will have everything complete. There will not be anything left behind. Maybe it's lacking in this way, it's lacking in this way. Maybe we are going to be managing it. You won't need to manage it. The right person, you will not need to manage anything. Everything will be there. Everything will be there. So you have to pray. Oh God, every fire, every power comes from the foundation. We want to pray that prayer again because the video cuts in the other side. Every fire from the foundation that is causing injuries and blockages and distractions in your mind, type of fire, type of fire, type of fire. Even though Jesus, from the power of my foundation, cause a distraction. Oh, so I read the only deal. Total distractions in the marriage, me. Total that, including me, if you're alone. Oh, no, no, patient, yo. Oh, no, no, marry, I'm my young, yo. Oh, no, if you're alone, yo, never, we come a shabby, papa, my son, come a smooch. Oh, talent, it's so, it's even, you might do. You say, once have I heard gospel, twice have I heard your power belong to God. Every power, cause destruction in my mind. That fire, in the name of Jesus. Every blockage spirit that is causing destruction, that wants me to make marital mistakes, because of that is causing destruction one way or the other. That by fire, that by fire. Let the power of the Most High God, let it come true now. In the name of Jesus, let the power of God, let it fight for me. Oh Lord, fight my battle. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, oh Lord, fight my battle. Have your battle, O Lord. In the name of Jesus, we have prayed. Amen. We thank God because He has answered our prayers. Amen. Then the next one you want to pray is, Lord, I don't know. Maybe some people have already prayed. We are just praying our prayers generally. We want to pray, O Lord, please. Sorry, I'm just trying to check this out so that I don't use more than the time you are supposed to use. We have to pray now. Oh God, please give me ear that listens, heart that obeys you when you want to speak. It's not easy to hear from God. I'm telling you, I want to reason why it's even easier, because there are so many things. We have our own thoughts. It happened to me like 2, 3, 4, or 5 days ago. Maybe 5 or 4, I can't remember the specific. There were so many things coming to my head. I didn't know how to recognize the voice of God. Anytime I tried to calm down to listen to the voice of God, what God was saying was difficult for me to understand. So, again, I shout, oh God, are you the one speaking? Again, so many thoughts will start coming, so many things will start coming. Now we have to pray. Oh God, see, as single sisters, don't go into marriage with a brother you don't pray through to. You're going to be the one to suffer for it in the marriage. See, I don't know, a lot of women in many churches, once a brother comes to pray to them, oh, I pray to you, oh, they will be so happy. Yes, 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 yes. Did you pray? Most of them, they just wait for one person to just come that I want to marry, and they just say, finally, I'm going to marry now. That is not how to do it. You have to pray. You have to know the will of God. It's not everybody you can marry, especially if you have a great destiny. It's not everybody you can marry. Did you pray? Did God say go? Was there an assurance? Was there revelations? Sometimes it may not even be true revelations, but one way or the other, God will speak to you. He will tell you. He will show you. He will explain to you. Do you know it is possible for you to know what is going on in someone's mind? Not your own mind, in another person's mind. It's possible when you pray. That is it. How do you know someone who is going to be able to work with you in your ministry? For you that you have a ministry, or maybe you that you want to become a CEO, because we have broken the curse that was placed on women that they should not be able to rise. We have removed the curse. The Lord has removed it from our head in Jesus. We will be able to rise in Jesus' name. Amen. We are not competing with men. We are not saying men should not rule or they should not have their own money. But we as women too, we must have our own money too. There's no big deal if you work as a woman and you're able to do a lot of things that a man can do. It's not a problem. So we have broken that curse. So what I'm just trying to say is that we need to pray. We need to pray for the power of God, the Spirit of God, the heart to listen, the mind to understand. Yeah, there's another thing again. Maybe it's mind that understands, maybe it's heart that understands, I don't know. Brain to understand, you know. If you want to take something from the realm of the Spirit, it's different from the realm of the world. So God needs to transcribe it in a way that you as a human being you need to understand. You know, there's times that God tells you some things, they'll be like, this is one of the reasons why He doesn't reveal things to people sometimes, because they will not believe. Sometimes what God is telling you looks difficult to believe. God is telling you, oh, I'm going to do this thing 1 year, 2 years, you have not seen it. Everybody will tell you, you are crazy to be waiting on the Lord. Who told you that God told you? If God told you, you would have done it. And yet, it doesn't mean God will not do it. When the prophecy came that a virgin will give birth to a child, it's not reasonable. First year, it didn't happen. Second year, until so many years. But it eventually happened. As human beings, we would have been saying, oh, it cannot happen. Oh, how will it happen? Oh, did God say it? Are you sure it's God? I said, look at Noah. When God told Noah that he should build the ark, that he's going to send flood. They didn't believe him because it looks difficult to believe. That is how God works. That is how to recognize the voice of God sometimes. It looks so unreal. But you have to really know it is the will of God for you. I'm not saying that everybody that you don't agree with is the will of God. But no, that's not what I'm saying. But what I'm saying is, it looks difficult to understand. But we want to pray now for the Spirit of God to understand it, the Spirit of God to hear it, the ear to hear it, the Spirit to understand it, the mind to understand it, to interpret it, to wait. Sometimes God will ask you to wait. The grace to wait, what we have to pray, time you have to pray, the time to pray, the grace to even pray. We need, let's pray for all these things I mentioned. Ah, Baba, mi ati Olorun mi, ore ofe lati gbadura, Baba fi fun mi. Father Lord, the grace to pray for the rightful partner, Father give to me. The ear to hear when you speak, Father give to me. The heart to understand when you speak, Father give to me. Oh Lord, the mind to interpret it, oh Lord. The vision for anything, not to misinterpret, oh Lord, my Father give to me. Oh Lord, please remove distractions. Remove distractions. Have mercy on me. Please, God, remove distractions from my heart. Father, Lord, the grace to be focused at the will of God for me. Father, Lord, give to me. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Now we want to pray. Maybe there are some people that are already in a wrong relationship. It's possible. It's possible. This is a general prayer. We're just trying to throw out our prayers in different angles as the Spirit of God is bringing it. That Lord, in those ways, if I am in a wrong relationship, or if I have pray through to the wrong person. Father Lord, come to my heart this night. Clear it away. Father Lord, one way or the other, cause a distraction and let that will of God come instead of the wrong one that I'm holding on to. Father, if I'm holding on to the wrong person for me, Father Lord, separate us. Father, in your own mighty hand of power, separate us. In your mightiness, separate us. Father Lord, in your mightiness, bring the right person. Let us pray. My God, my Father, Father Lord, if I am holding on to the wrong person, I am interpreting in my head that, oh, this wrong person is the right person. Father Lord, tonight I pray. Remove this evil thought from my mind. In the name of Jesus. And I pray, oh Lord, Father, the right person, Father, bring him right now. In the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, bring him right now. In the name of Jesus. Father Lord, every evil relationship that I'm in, oh Lord, Father Lord, scatter it now in the name of Jesus. And I pray, anybody that is really in any evil wrong relationship, Father, scatter it in the name of Jesus. Father Lord, as we are praying, Father, we want the will of God. Oh Lord, this prayer looks difficult, it looks so unexplainable, but we just want to do the will of God. Father Lord, scatter the evil wrong relationship in the name of Jesus. Father, let the will of God come through and let the power of God take charge. In the name of Jesus, have your will, Lord. Have your will, Lord. Most High God, come and take control. Jesus Christ, come and take charge. Jesus Christ, have your way. Jesus Lord, take glory. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen. The Lord bring the righteous person to us in Jesus' name. Amen. Then you want to pray. You know, another thing in this life, sometimes you have met the righteous person for you. The one thing we just happen, you think, oh, this person is not the right person for me. The person will just go. And maybe, oh, man's up, oh, no, man, they can't feel called as your boyfriend. The person you think is not right for you. Maybe it's the person that's right for you. Oh, Lord. Or maybe someone has used juju or charm or anything. Now you them tell your man, feed the balko. You understand? Like, oh, you have anything like that. Or seduction, whatever, sweet mouth, sweet talk. Maybe somebody have used it to collect your husband. That's why I said, married women, this prayer too is for you. So we want to pray, oh Lord, whatever way that the rightful person for me has been taken away from me forcefully, this night I take him back forcefully in the name of Jesus. Let's pray. My God, my Father, and whatever way that the rightful person for me has been taken away from me, Father, Lord, forcefully, Father, I too, I take him back forcefully this night in the name of Jesus. I reject him back forcefully in the name of Jesus. Take him back forcefully in the name of Jesus. This night I take him back forcefully in the name of Jesus. When David, when everything was taken away from him as Ziklag, he said he had that prophecy. He said, should I pursue? He said, you should pursue. He said, he will recover and he will overtake and he will recover. And he overtook you and he recovered everything. Father, this night, everything that has been forcefully taken away from me, I recover back. In the name of Jesus, I take back my divine husband. In the name of Jesus, and I remember that has been taken away with charm or juju or seduction, breasts, nyash, sweet mouth talks or anything, or always trying to be of appearance to him at every time, that refusing to take him away from me forcefully. Father, I take him back forcefully this night in the name of Jesus. Take him to my Lord back forcefully in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. I pray that this prayer will be answered for every married woman to in Jesus. Every married woman that one of the time your husband has been stolen away from you, the power of God will restore your marriage in the name of Jesus. Because the will of God is, you can't remarry as a Christian. You can't remarry. You have to do the will of God. Except if you don't want to do the will of God again. But if you want to do the will of God, you have to wait and do the will of God and take your husband back. So the last prayer we want to pray now is, oh Lord, for some ladies, they don't even know what God wants them to do. Now I want to pray, oh Lord, please give me a divine assignment. Open my eyes to know my divine assignment. What am I called for? So that I'll be able to know when the right person that can do this ministry with me comes along. Now I'll be able to pray through to that person. Because if you don't know where you are going, you will just marry anybody. You marry anybody, you just pick anybody and you go there, you start struggling. Once you know where you're going, you can't pick just anybody. You have to pick who is going with you. Even people that are not Christians, they know these things. Look at our popular actress, Toni Abraham. She said she had always wanted to marry an actress, an actor like herself, because she knows that person will understand her. And we understand that type of career, she will not need to explain herself every time. That is the same thing with whatever you want to do. So this night, as a woman, let us pray. Father Lord, establish me, O Lord, divinely, in all aspects, in secular job. Father, I want you to establish me. Father, I want you to give me a ministry of yourself. I want you to open my eyes to what you want me to do. So that when it is right time to pick the right person, I will be able to know what you want me to do, and I'm going to pick the right person for the assignment you have given me to me. Let's pray. Most of all, I pray this. Father, open my eyes to see this divine assignment you have given unto me, Lord, in Jesus' name. I pray as many people that are still outside there that are still saying, oh, it's whatever my husband will do that I will do. Father, I pray that this night you open every eyes in the name of Jesus to be able to see, oh, that we as ladies, we are not just here to be here. For being here, we are here for a purpose, and so we created us so that we can fulfill destiny and not just to just live and just be there like that. Father Lord, please have mercy. Oh my Father, please give me a divine assignment for your glory. Father, open my eyes to see. Open our eyes to see, Lord. Don't let us go in our own way in the name of Jesus. Almighty Father, take control. Father, open our eyes to see the will of God for us. Father, Lord, open our eyes to know what you want us to do in life. Father, Lord, please, and those of us that are loving me, Father, come and establish us. Father, make it great in the name of Jesus. Father, let our star rise in the star, in the sky, worldwide in the name of Jesus. Let people know the us. Let them see the will of God through our lives in Jesus' name. Amen. Thank you, Jesus, for the answer prayers. Oh, Jesus, in our prayer, that we want to round up by saying that whatever we have laid our hands on, that God should bless it. Maybe those of us that are going to school, those of us that are doing one trade or the other, those of us that we are into business or we are into jobs or anything, that God should come and bless us and establish and make us great. In Jesus, we don't want to just be women of small money. We want to be women of big money. A lot of women are buying big cars nowadays. We want to join them too. We don't want to be in the group of women that are just roaming about the streets. Some women are still roaming about this. We don't want to be in that carcass. We want to be among women of caliber and timber of the society. When men are standing or sitting trying to give points, we want to be able to say things too. We want to be able to say some things, not just some the kind of woman that they will close the door, you just be inside the room because you don't have anything in your head you want to see. You don't want to be that kind of woman. Father, to come and bless us, establish us the morning we need to rise in light, the ones you give us in Jesus' name. Father Lord, please come and establish us. Father, come and bless us. Father Lord, Father, bless the works of our hands. Father Lord, I am studying. Father, bless the works of my hands. I'm doing business. Father, bless my business. All the things you have told me to be doing. Father, come and bless it in the name of Jesus Christ. Father Lord, establish me. Father Lord, let my star rise. All those that need to come to the rising of my star so that they can bless me. Father Lord, let them come in the name of Jesus. Oh Lord, you said that princes, people that I don't know, they will be servants unto me. Father Lord, come and do so in my life in Jesus' name. Father Lord, raise me up. Lift me up. Don't let me be a one person that is just on the same ground every time that I want to want my life to move forward. I want to press forward in Jesus' name. Amen. We thank God for tonight's prayer. I'm so grateful to God. You know, I didn't know I could do a 1 hour prayer line. This is the first of its kind, and I thank God for making it a reality. Praise God. So we want to end our prayers now by giving praises to God. Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord, Father, your grace. We thank you, Lord Jesus. It's not by our power, it is by your power, oh Lord. Father, Lord, we said we appointed this day and you appointed it for us and you made it possible and you prepared everything according to your plan. Be magnified in Jesus' name. Father, Lord, we are going into Father, Lord, all the blessings and the miracles you have done for us in this prayer, Father Lord, let it be permanent in Jesus' name. Father Lord, I pray as many that we look at this video again, Father Lord, let everybody be filled with the power of God. Father, and those of us that have been blessed through this prayer, Father Lord, may the blessing be permanent in Jesus' name. All what we have received through this prayer, Father Lord, we collect them back, we're fine. And let them be powerless in our lives in Jesus' name. We pray that we don't make mistakes mentally in Jesus' name. We pray that we don't be lower standard kind of woman. We'll be high standards in Jesus' name. We're going to fulfill our destiny in Jesus' name. And the rightful man that can match our destiny, the Lord will give them to us in Jesus' name. We pray, amen. Thank you so much for joining me while we started doing. I appreciate your comments, your likes, everything, your views. I really appreciate. Thank you. Good night. Bye.